Okay. So, what we are going to have today, okay, and today discussion, whatever we will be doing in next 1.5 hour, what I would like to, I'll give soft copy whatever I'm using, okay. I would like to just request all of you, please go through that practical session with your own, on your own system. Okay, it's very important and it's very easy also. Okay, very important, very easy. Okay, now the very first thing, we got little bit basic idea what we all are talking about, performance tuning. Performance tuning means maybe there are different component we know. So in different component, different tools are available. Tools like different reporting kind, maybe we have heard only, not gone through it, like some report like ADDM report, AWR report, ASH report. Naming wise, we all have gone through. Few of us have a little bit good idea on it. Okay, but apart from that, normally day-to-day activity wise, from the development team, we used to get request saying that, okay, these are the SQL statement. Can you please check whether it is good or bad? Good or bad means what? Because output they are going to get same or they are getting same. Way of writing command is little bit different. Sir, what exactly it means? It means in performance, this, if I'm writing one statement saying select star from table name, okay, where salary is greater than 10,000, okay. And salary less than 20,000, okay? Whatever number. Same, this is one statement. And the second statement, what I'm writing, same select star from table name where cell between this and it, between 10,000 or 10,000 and 20,000 something. One statement we are writing, this is one set, okay? So in both the scenario, what do you think? Output are going to be same or different? Output for
Same,
both
sir.
the
Output will be same,
is
sir.
same, right?
Yes, same,
Another
sir.
example I'm giving. Okay. Say, for example, we are having select star from EMP where department ID equal to 10 or department ID equal to 20 or department ID. Likewise, we can give n number, okay? Maybe 10 or 15 departments. So either of this, if anybody is working, we will be getting output. This is the first one. And the same statement I'm writing, everything is going to be same other than this last one. The difference is going to be this one where department ID in 10, comma 20, comma 30. So if this is one statement and this is the where clause I only change, Are the output for both the queries same or different?
Same, sir.
Same. Likewise, we can go for n number of examples. I'll come a little bit more options what we have, just to give you guys clear picture. If both output or both way we are going to get the same output, which one is best and why? And whenever we are talking about, so far what we have learned, whatever SQL statement while learning, we used to get assignment, we are just simply getting the output should be as per expectation. That's it. We never discussed or we never thought on the output from performance point of view. Because you all are saying, okay, sir, both are same. Yes, output wise, both are same. But performance, if somebody will ask, okay, from development, we are getting, okay, both the thing is there. Can you suggest which one is good or why? Why part is, it's okay. They're not going to ask. If they are asking also, it's up to you. But we need to understand which one is good and how to prove it is a good one. Because you can say, okay, go for it. But it might happen, if you're not clear with, it might happen earlier query was or report was coming in 5 seconds. Now it started coming 30 seconds. We need to understand how internal query get processed. Okay, so there is a standard practice we use to follow, or as a DBA, that is applicable to development team also, but most of the time, we are not following it. Maybe knowingly, most of the time, unknowingly. But to start with, though, the volume of that application is pretty low, it used to work okay. But after few months or maybe few years, the same query, nothing got changed. Though the volume of data got many fold, the output is start getting very slow, or the response time started getting very, very bad. Earlier, 5 seconds, now 1 minute. But some optimum time is there, right? How long people will wait for one report? They know earlier it was working in this, so he made, but one point of time they will ask question or they will start escalating the stuff. And on that situation, thing will come first to DBA. We never did anything. Why it is happening differently? It's a database problem. But if we know the best practices, by just knowing the query, we can directly suggest that, okay, you have written this greater than 1,000 and less than, just better use between. You have written this or this or this, better write in this way. You have written some join in this way, better use that way. So all those options, first we need to know, and we need to justify with proof. What proof? Yes, it is taking less time, and why it is taking less time. Okay, so this is the whole objective of today's session. Okay, and to do that, we are going to have, because the table what we have used so far is having very less records. Mostly we have used what? The HR and Scott. These two Scott we have used. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'll just use any one of this table, take example of HR, and I will show you which query is going to take more time. Same way, either of these two or a few more I'll take and show you that output is same, but time is different and why it is taking longer time. That is most important part. Okay. So hope it's clear what we are going to do in next 1.5 hour to all of us. Simple. Writing SQL, what are the rules we are going to follow from performance perspective or performance point of view. And to do so, there are n number of tools available in Oracle. And one of the main tool what we are going to discuss right now is, let me just take a new page. So this is one part as an introduction, but how to fulfill or how to get the report saying it is going to take less time, how we are going to prove it. For that, we should have at least few options or some the performance related tool that will prove us, okay, this is the problem, this is good. And that can be done with the options. Suppose we are sitting on SQL, okay? So we have to write very basic, simple command, okay? I'm repeating, one type of task can be done in different ways. My focus will be at least give you guys clear picture or clear picture on one or two of, okay? One or maybe two. Concepts are going to be just same. Maybe using techniques are going to be different. Okay, so one or two way I will show you how to check the performance of the SQL statement. Okay, and the output what we are going to see, the output is going to be same on the other tool or technique available in Oracle. Okay, so what is that tool or technique, or what are the things we are going to learn? So the things is, or so far from day one, we used to heard one thing called optimizer. So two term, it's known term to us. Okay, so hope we all are aware with optimizer and execution plan. Okay, at least introduction wise. So we will have one line answer. Okay, I'll take only two answer for that. If somebody will ask us, what is optimizer? How we are going to come as a means answer? How we'll go going to just reply? Optimizer, what is optimizer? Anyone?
So it's an algorithm.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Any other?
Sir, optimizer mainly helps to choose the most efficient execution plan. Means by based of CBA or CBO or RBO.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So we don't know what is CBO, what is RBO. We don't know right now. But the question is optimizer. Answer should be, or whatever answer you both have gave, it's okay, it's nothing wrong it, but to be more specific, optimizer is a program inside Oracle. That program's responsibility is to choose best execution plan. Okay, so a number of plans are available. Optimizer will just make a decision which one is good or bad. So definitely it will just choose the best one. So definitely inside it, what program means, what it's algorithm, it's an instruction, different kind of logic, those things are available, right? Now the next question is, okay, if somebody will ask us, what is the execution plan, how are we going to answer it?
Sir, the execution plan would be a modified SQL statement, no?
Is it that? Any no, this is not good. Okay, we can try.
Hello sir, I would like to give a try.
Yeah, sure.
So depending on the SQL statement, say there are, I guess, clauses of the statements, and according to the execution plan, it is being defined already which part of which clause of the SQL statement will be executed first among the total of the SQL statement joining all the clauses. So if there is a where clause or any statement, if there is a where clause and then having clause, just for a random example, so the execution plan will be decided based on the priority of the execution among those clauses. So which clause will be executed first, and then so that's the execution plan, I guess, in a whole.
Perfect. Good. Now, I'm repeating the same thing. Let me be a little different. So, execution plan is basically, ultimately, this plan is built on what? The query we are writing, right? If you remember, I wrote a couple of query, right, on the first page. Select this, where salary between this and this, department this or this or this or in this, right? So the execution plan is nothing other than the blueprint given by optimizer or choose by optimizer. That blueprint will just tell us which way the SQL output will be fetched. That means this is the total entire the steps how the query is going to fetch data. So fetching data, before fetching data, definitely it is going to just get it into it, right? First, like we used to use different clauses, like maybe where clause, maybe group by clause, maybe some keyword we are using, max, min, like different functions we are using, right? So different functions are there. So n number of constructs or n number of options or n number of logics we are putting in one SQL statement, which will execute first and which will come next. If the statement we are writing, whether internally index will be used or not, it might happen index is available, still index is not going to be used. Why or how? At least we all have basic idea about index, right? Yes or no? Whoever know, just you can ping me. We
No,
all have
sir.
basic idea that, okay,
I don't
index
have
means.
any idea about index. Index
No,
was not a part.
also.
No.
I have also.
Okay, so normally, forget about Oracle. Do you have the basic about normal? Suppose we are not learning Oracle. Do we have basic understanding or indexes in our books?
Yes.
Index is the last
Yes, sir.
part. So,
These are
what
the
is the
last
purpose?
pages of the book.
Yeah. So, what is the purpose of it? The purpose is, if we want to do some fast search or fast stuff. Suppose you want to search for one keyword. So do we go through page by page? No, right?
No, sir, we
What we
directly
do?
go to that page.
Yes, we'll go to the last page and we'll search. There's a alphabet or whichever way is organized, and we are going to get that page number. And directly, we are just trying to go to maybe if it is 1,000 pages, so half, then half. Likewise, we are just getting into specific word pretty faster, right? So, depending on the question, what I want to ask you to search for, you will decide whether I'll go to index page or should I search page by page, right? If I'll ask you out of 1,000 pages, maybe whatever word I'm going to give you, it is available almost every page. So do you go and search in the index and go come to the page? No, right? What you will do in that case? You're going to go search page by page, right? Because search option is so huge, index is not going to make a sense at all. So here, if we don't know index, simple answer is we'll discuss index in detail, right? Index, lot of things we have to cover. Start with basic, okay? But index is basically, it is going to help or execute the, or to get the query pretty fast. So the bottom line here, execution plan is going to give us the concrete picture. By just looking into this, you will come to know how it is going to display the route. The entire steps are written. Okay, first it will do this, then this, then this, then this. Whether in this, along with this, it will tell you what is the cost. Cost means how much CPU percentage is getting used. Okay, how each and every step wise, which all other rows are getting filtered. Every detail you will get rows filter. Okay. Then whether it is using index or not, just like, as I told you that maybe indexes are available in your book, but not always you are going to use index. How to prove you are using, means how you are going to prove that index is available in our that specific table where we are going to write query on which, but whether it is using it or not. If not using, what is the cost? And whenever I'm talking about cost, it is normally the CPU along with that, whatever the search it is doing. Search means it might be a full or table full search, or it is index search. Okay. So definitely it is, if it is showing us full search, it is going to take long time to get the output. If it is doing index search, there are chance that the output is going to be pretty fast. So all these basic thing we will come to know through this execution plan. And once this plan is done, then the Oracle process will start doing processing. So normally we used to discuss, or I used to give one example, like from here to maybe Howrah station, there are 4 to 5 routes are available, right? So out of that 4 to 5 route, which route you are going to choose? So definitely to make final decision, you are going to go, means going to observe or going to just think on a few points. What are those points? I want to go to Howrah from Baguyati. I know 4 to 5 route. Can anyone tell me what all are the option I'll go for? Means before making a decision.
It will just depend on time, how much time we
very
have.
Good. So let me just note down, because this is very, very important. Very basic, but very important. We miss this one. So one is time kitna lagega konsa route mein, right?
And another each cost.
Yes, very good. So cost, cost means yeah, hum log paisa ke baat kar rahe, theek hai? Matlab bhaada kitna lagega, theek hai? So cost means so time, how long it will take, cost, what else? Bolo. Comfort, matlab bus se jayenge ya kisse jayenge? Just a moment.
Sir, another thing will be the scenario. मतलब कौन सा सिचुएशन में आप जाना चाह रहे हो? With any oldest person या फिर आप अकेला हैं सर?
Exactly. So here, comfort is there. Then one thing we will keeping in mind or consider, we should not miss the train, right? मतलब हावड़ा स्टेशन कैसे जाना, ट्रेन ही पकड़ना ना. सो ट्रेन मिस नहीं, द पर्पस शुड बी मींस शुड रिजॉल्व. सब कुछ लिए, पैसा बचाया, सब कुछ कम कम लिया, ट्रेन ही नहीं मिला. दैट मींस हियर व्हाटएवर थिंग वी आर गिविंग, ultimately the output is not coming. What is fun of having that plan? What else? Tell me. Time kitna lagega?
Sir, situation.
Situation that is the situation. Like we should not miss the train, right? So yes. we should get the output within a specific point of time, right? So here only cost, lot of things are coming, right? Cost ko bachane ke liye kya kya? Bus se jaye, ya yellow taxi se jaye, ya Ola Uber se jaye, theek hai? Ya agar personal gaadi hai, personal gaadi se. So lot of things are available. So isme depending on the right now, suppose corona ka samay hai, right? So definitely we will prefer our own car if it is with us. So the bottom line, what we are trying to understand here, before making final decision, we will be asking these questions, right? Or we have to go through all these options. Or isme se jo sabse optimum rahega. What exactly it means optimum? Matlab jaise hum log bolte hai na ki सस्ता और मतलब सस्ता और पुष्टिकर जो हो, मतलब मेरा काम भी हो जाए एकदम, मतलब बहुत जल्दी मेरा आउटपुट भी दिखे और लोड भी, लोड इन द सेंस यहाँ पे खर्चा भी काफी कम हो, राइट? दैट इज द ऑप्टिमम थिंग व्हाट ऑप्टिमाइजर विल लुक फॉर. प्लान तो बहुत है, हावड़ा से मैं पूरा नया ब्रिज से जाऊंगा तो ज्यादा पैसा लगेगा, पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट से जाऊंगा तो रिक्स है बहुत, मतलब अनकम्फर्ट होगा, एंड बट अल्टीमेटली वी आर गोइंग टू सेव मनी, बट इसमें टाइम भी ज्यादा लगेगा. सो एन नंबर फैक्टर्स आर देयर व्हेन वी आर ट्रैवलिंग, दैट इज वन ऑफ द मेन पॉइंट. इफ वी विल गो इन द पिकार, सो डेफिनेटली वी विल चूज सम डिफरेंट रूट, मे बी बड़ा बाजार होके इधर से होके निकल जाएंगे, मीन्स नॉन पिकार में, बट इन पिकार है डेफिनेटली वी विल रेडी टू स्पेंड सम मोर टाइम, अदरवाइज बड़ा बाजार के जाम में फंसे वी आर 100% श्योर वी आर गोइंग टू मिस आवर ट्रेन. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो वी नीड टू टेक केयर. Now, all these things we have discussed, 4, 5, or 6 points, on what basis this input is, or it should be there with you, कि टैक्सी से भाड़ा कितना लगेगा, बस से कितना लगेगा, बस से पहुंचने में मेरे को ट्रेन तो मिस नहीं होगा. So, those inputs should be there with you. Suppose it's not peak hour, you are catching bus with some XYZ route, you found that due to whatever meeting, that road is closed. What do you do on that time? It's a mess, right? So all these input, whatever input here we are discussing, before making final execution plan, optimizer will or should have all those information based on the table which you are going to work on, or SQL statement you are going to execute on. So in our case, which one? This one, we are using which table? Employee table, right? So to run the query, to build the execution plan, optimizer should have all these kind of information, else it will not able to make good decision. Like you travel to Howrah maybe 5 years back, and in last 5 years, you are not having any idea what is going on in the traffic. Might be 5 years back, whichever situation was there, right now it's totally opposite. So if you will not have whatever last 5 year status, whatever news, whatever new route, new rule, maybe some new, maybe options like metro is there, so better take metro, go till whatever station you want, and from there. So if you will have all the latest information. When you are going to travel, you will able to make perfect decision. But if you are not having all those information, like 5 years back, no AC buses were running from Baguiati to, or 10 years back, Baguiati to Howrah. Right now it's running. So if that information is not there with me, I'll not think of just traveling to bus, because that input is not there with me. Resulted, maybe I know at means the new route or the new rule given by government is saying every 10 minutes there are two AC buses are going to or running from Baguiati to this, and those buses are almost half full. And what I'm doing, I'm just making decision, okay, I'll book car and I'll go. So yellow taxi, maybe fare is maybe 4-5 times more. Comfort is again very bad compared to AC bus. I'm traveling alone. So if the input proper, whatever the infra proper status is not there with me, I will not able to make a good decision. So all these input I'm talking about, what is that input in case of optimizer, on the basis of that it will make a decision. Because optimizer will give 2-3 options out of, means the n number of options are available. So out of that, optimizer will take the best one. On what basis? As I told you, to go to Howrah, n number of options are available. Which should I prefer and why? Same thing. N number of options might be available. Plans are available. Which one is the best plan? On what basis optimizer will decide? Sometime you might be getting almost same time, maybe 5 minutes different. You'll be getting X plan, you'll be getting Y plan later. Why, how? Definitely something is helping optimizer to make decision, this plan or that plan. What is that part? So question is clear what I'm asking. First, tell me that one. What are the factor, okay, is coming in consideration while choosing the best plan? Just like, which are the factor will help me to make decision to go to Howrah? These are the factor. We will think of all these things. So that input is there with me, then only I'll be able to make decision, good decision. If input, the correct status is not there with me, I will ended up with very wrong decision. I might miss train. I might made into train, but with lot of cost. Jo bus se mera 50 rupees mein ho jata, main taxi se, I'm using maybe 500 or 300 rupees on that. So it is not the optimum one. So here the optimizer will make decision on the basis of something technically we might be knowing it, or few of you might not be knowing, is called statistic. Okay. Now, what is that statistic or stats one we are referring to? Okay. Anybody have heard it? What statistic? Kuch logo pata hai, mere ko pata hai, but who will come? What is statistic? Suman ko
chhod. Sir, all metadata about table, sir.
Okay. I'll come with answer. I'll write 3-4 thing.
Sir, answer, actually,
one by one, huh? Just a minute. Metadata I'm writing. Okay. And then we will metadata. Yes, two. Bolo, Swan.
Statistics, sir, whenever any incident or any event occurred in database, that incident and event on the basis of that incident or the event, and the data has been stored, means which if memory has reached to this person, this type of data has been stored. These are called the statistics.
Can you be a little bit more specific? I can understand what you're trying to tell, but the things are not coming in clear way. So can you try one more time? It's the same thing, but question is, what is statistic? Because on the basis of that statistic, optimizer is going to choose this or that, it will which plan will be go will go. So what it is, or you can directly tell statistic means, sir, these are the things. Because here, as a layman, it's not going to be clear what you are saying. If you know somebody knows, then it's clear. For me, it's clear what you are trying
previous,
to say.
Previous events.
Events, okay. I'll take mode 2, okay. Metadata event or anybody else?
Sir, actually, sir, it's a record of the modified data resulting out of an event which was in turn triggered by some process.
Okay, so yeah, it's a directly you're referring to event only, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
At least, sir, the reactions to the events.
Yeah, reaction to event. Okay. What else? It's coming in under that only, what you're referring.
Okay.
Hello, sir. Sir, hello.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, statistics helps to check that which one is better performing.
No, that we know. But question is, what is statistic? That is the question, right? Okay. Suman, can you try? What is statistic? Any idea on it?
मुझे लग रहा है कि आपने पिछले दिन में जो बोला था वही मतलब इसमें कितना statistics का मतलब है मेरा डेटास में जितना सारा इवेंट्स है जितना सारा ऑब्जेक्ट्स है सबका बारे में जो डेटा रहता है वही है statistics जिसमें सब रहेगा मतलब डेटा वॉल्यूम ईच एंड एवरीथिंग विल बी देयर प्रेजेंस इंक्लूडिंग ऑल ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स
मेन थिंग वी आर मिसिंग एंड दैट इज द सिंपल आंसर वी कैन गिव नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स ओके स्टैटिस्टिक मीन्स हियर If you just make any or write any SQL statement where we are writing on, what is the base? Base is the table, right? We are writing a SQL statement on what? From where? The table, right?
Yes. So
the whole processing is getting done on records available in the tables, right? So what you all are saying event related thing that will help us or whatever metadata those metadata will help us to find out what is going on into database right so that is definitely one of the statistic apart from that the one part what we are missing in this context is the total detail whenever here we are saying metadata what we are referring here metadata we are the picture is there in our mind is metadata means ek table hai wo kab bana tha right who is the owner what all are the permission that metadata we are referring to correct but here the statistic what we all are trying to discuss or trying to get is suppose a table called EMP ठीक है in this EMP which all are the number of columns available see so definitely columns are there 5 column Next, what all are the number of rows available? 10,000, 10 lakh, or 10 million, or a billion. Okay, so that now each and every, what is the average size of the rows? Now, whether this table have any index or not? What next? Whether this table have partition or not? If partition we don't know, we will be doing it. But these are the things basically. On specific object, each and every bit of it. Bit of it, I'm saying that each and every columns. Suppose size of name is worker, we have given 30. Okay, but out of the 30, what is the average length name? That means average character is what, 20 or 10 or 25? What is the average length or average size of that particular column's value? Even, just this is very important, a little deep also. What kind of records you have in the table? What kind of records, like suppose department name is there, right? So out of that 10 lakh record, how many number of times department called HR occur? How many number of time maybe admin occur? If you're talking about name, how many number of time name called, suppose X, is getting repeated? Each and every bit and pieces on that table. All those information clubbing together, we are saying statistic on that specific table. When we are talking about that, those event or those statistic where the clear picture of what is happening, like MRI, I said MRI of the entire database. So when table got created, one event, which all are the different type of lock is getting involved, that event. When you did a bulk load in the table, that event, that is also stats. But here we are focusing on the object, means table here called EMP, and more deeper into distribution or the type or the nature of records we have inside table, that part we are referring. Okay, depending on that, because if one table is there and it has till morning, it was only 1,000 row was there. And in next 10 hour, right now is 1 lakh records are there. Plan for this 1,000 record and plan for 1 lakh record is going to be totally different. So if 1,000 or 1 lakh, this latest update, what you did 1 lakh records, if the information is not available to optimizer, optimizer will do mistake, right? What I told you, I want to go from here to Howrah. I don't have that update that one or two every hour or every maybe 10 minute AC buses are running. So I'm not going to use it, right? So ultimately the cost is going to be very high. If that information is not there with me, very high. So the information says here 1 lakh record is already inserted into table. that input is not available to optimizer, optimizer is not going to make good plan to fetch the data from the table called EMP. So the blueprint here, what we said or discussed, that is going to be wrong, because optimizer will choose the plan on the basis of the statistic available on that object, object here table called employee. Sir, how to get a statistic is not Oracle is taking or coming with automatically. This is the internal stuff, right? Because our aim, maybe developer or DBA, is to just look into. Developer will insert data and we will see whether the table, whatever space, table space, space or size, everything well and means perfectly all right or not. This is the internal stuff. What we will do, what DBA will do in this.
Just starts together. As a DBA.
So, yes. So some mechanism is there. Okay. Some techniques are there. Few are automated. 10 onwards, basically, to be more specific, 11 version onwards, the stats gather used to happen automatically in the midnight. Midnight, okay? 12, midnight. By default, if we are... So stats gather means what? Stats gather means all these, like you have inserted 1 lakh record. That is going to be updated where? Which table? Definitely data dictionary table. Which data dictionary table?
So base tables.
Yeah, definitely everything is there going to be base table only. But for us, we cannot use directly base table, right? So we should know which table to look into. Like whether this particular 1 lakh record is available. So that latest, this information is already went somewhere. How to check whether that update is already there with that table or not? We as a DBA have to make sure that if some kind of activity like this happen, the statistics should be updated. Stats should be there. How to check where the stats is all available? How to find out if the latest stats is available on the table or not? Most important question. This you can make a note. How we will come to know that one specific table, this is one of the day-to-day activity we all used to do. Maybe you are having DBA 1 year experience, or I'm having around maybe 20 or 30 or maybe 10 or 15, whichever number. These are the basic thing we should know all. How you will come to know that the table called EMP in our case is eligible for stats gather. Matlab, iske upar, in this table, how to find out this table is eligible for gathering stats, or the candidate for stats gather, or in which situation we will come to know.
Sorry, voice is breaking.
The voice is breaking for everyone.
No, sir.
Yes, perfect. Sir. For mine, it's okay.
Okay, so maybe you can check whoever is just saying. You can maybe little
sir, bit. From me, it's perfect. Okay.
Anyone is perfect, so I'm good then. So you can check. Okay, so what I was saying, that the table is there called employee. How you will come to know that the table is the candidate for stats gather? इस टेबल के ऊपर स्टैटिस्टिक जनरेट और गैदर करने का करना जरूरी है, अदरवाइज वी विल बी एंडिंग विथ वेरी बैड प्लान रिजल्टिंग विथ इंस्टेड ऑफ 5 सेकेंड आउटपुट इज कम गोइंग टू कम इन 15 मिनट मे बी इट विल हैंग द आउटपुट विल नॉट कम एट ऑल इट हैपेंस एंड यू विल गो gather the statistic, within fraction of second output will come. So how to find out? So we will get answer for all those things. So to conclusion, what all are the things we are going to focus on? I'll show you what all are the best practices at least we should have for writing SQL statement. Difference I made it, okay, this or that, which one is best. How to prove this is best or bad. And to prove this, how we need to know something, some tool, okay, that I'll show you how to use that tool. And by using that tool, we will come to know something called execution plan. We have basic idea what is execution plan is. What basic idea I'm expecting now, at least how the statement will execute. Simply I'll run simple select star from EMP and I'll show you, see, this is a plan. This is all about execution plan. But definitely the more complex query you will write, the more complex plan will be there with you. And that plan itself will tell you whether while getting the output, it is going to do the full search or full scan, full table scan, or it is going to use index. Mostly whenever we are going to use index, you will able to see the cost is pretty less. If it is doing full table scan, you will come to know a lot of cost is there. Cost here I'm referring to CPU, maybe percentage, it will show maybe 3, 4, 5, 10, 15, 20. That should be minimum. More less the number, more quicker the query, simple. So in next few minutes, you will come to know what is or how it will look like and what number we will be looking and what to do. So the number should be coming always lesser and lesser and lesser. If it is more and more and more, the query time is going to be taking more and more and more. And the third one I'll tell you, stats table, on the specific table, whether statistic gather is needed or not. And the basic one, when the last statistic was gathered on that table. As I told you earlier, by default, midnight, all the database statistic used to gather. But for our production systems, normally this we used to do change. Mostly we used to disable it. Why? Stats gathering process is very costly process. That means we will come to know average size kya hai, different type of one type of value. Suppose I said HR kitne bar hai out of 1 million or maybe 1 billion record. To find out a specific record kitne bar hai, it is very time taking. And in a database, thousands of tables used to be there. One table size in heavy system in terabyte. So it's not means simply blindly run statistic on all the table or keep it like that. No, if you'll do so, unnecessary, entire system might be hanging. So we have to be very careful, and that is the reason. So these 3-4 points, let's start. Okay, so before I can move to practical session, any basic confusion in this so far? Because here I just touched the basic, like execution plan. Okay, blueprint, it will show us this thing. I'll show you. Also, stats means I already told you that. Okay, stat means number of row kitna hai, what is the distribution, average row size kya hai, which all are the values like HR or how many number of occurrence, all those things, even what sizes took, that is also coming under statistic. When the last stats gather was there, that is also statistic. Okay, so any question in this, whatever basic few three part I have mentioned here? So if not, I'm just going to show these things slowly.
सर आई थिंक सर चैट में कोई कुछ क्वेश्चन किया है किसी ने।
नहीं वो शायद आंसर दिए।
वो सेंसर से फिर क्वेश्चन निकलेगा, स्टेल क्या है,
स्टेल क्या है।
जो भी आंसर दिया है उस स्टेल का मतलब एक बार वहां पे समझा के लिख दो, तब तक मैं इधर सेट कर रहा हूँ, बाकी सब लोग पढ़ लेंगे। ओके सो फॉर दैट लेट मी गेट, आई एम जस्ट फॉर अ मिनट आई एम अनशेयरिंग माई स्क्रीन। ओके लेट मी एक्सट्रैक्ट फ्यू फाइल्स and then I'll present it again, okay? So, or better just, we can take 5 minute break here. In the meanwhile, I'm just doing setup, so you can take bio break. If you don't have anything, you can sit 5 minute, okay? It's 8:07, so we'll start at maybe 12:13. In a minute, I'll be just doing the setup. Okay, I'm back.
Yes, sir.
I hope we all are here. So I'm just going to, I already share very few basic query with that, means which one is good and bad. Same good and bad thing we are trying to prove here. Okay, and whatever discussion we have so far, on the basis of that, we'll try to focus and clear the concept. Okay, and to have a little bit more data, one procedure is there. By running that procedure, we will have maybe number of rows, records, few handful of maybe 1,000 to 2,000 records we will put, and it will give us a little bit more clear picture about the output what we are going to get. On the statement what we have with us. I already text you the same statement. I'll simply copy paste and show you same thing you all will be doing with your own. Okay, so let me share my screen. I hope you all are able to see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
And just to give you a little idea what it is there, I know none of us have idea about PL SQL. Ultimately, what it is doing, one table is there, if you see, because when you will run, if it is not going to work okay, you might be panic. So the table called EMP, here we are creating. So EMP table should be there in your user or schema where you are going to do practice. Okay, so EMP, and one more thing, if you'll see here, from it is taking this, and here also one more thing, let me into, yeah, so make sure you have table called EMP. Second thing, make sure you have all these column. So if you'll compare, the by default, we have a table called employee under HR schema. So please run this statement inside HR and it will give us the proper output. And output is nothing, ultimately it is creating one, means one table. Inside this table, we are going to have number of records. Okay, 3,000. Once we will run this statement or this particular procedure, 3,000 record will be inserted in the table. If you run two time, maybe 6,000. Every run, 3,000 record will be inserted. So ultimate aim of running or using this statement to get a little bit more volume in the table, because in actual scenario we used to have millions of records. We are not going to have million, but to get a feel that 8-10,000 is okay. So first we will do what? We will run this particular SQL statement, okay? Whatever so-called procedure what you all have received. Okay, any question on this? Why we are doing it? More to have more number of record in a table, we are doing it. How it is working, it's none of our business, okay? Only the reason I told EMP tables should be there, otherwise it won't work. So how it is going to, how you all are going to practice, I'm just going to show you, okay? On the basis of that, you start doing. So let me whatever step I'm going to do, some same thing you can just follow. And sample schema is there. If not, you can create one table just like employee table we have in HR, and that's it.
Sir, एक चीज पूछना था आपको, मतलब ये related तो इसपे नहीं है. वो आपने AWR report के बारे में बताया था ना, मतलब जिस दिन इसके लिए, तो उसके लिए कोई मतलब session है, मतलब जिसमें AWR report को पढ़ेंगे हम लोग, मतलब ऊपर से stack analysis करने के लिए ना?
करेंगे करेंगे करेंगे. तो ये थोड़ा जान लेने, तो ये सब नहीं जानने से ना,
हाँ नहीं नहीं, मैं इसलिए मैं बोल रहा हूँ, मैं इसलिए आपको बोल रहा हूँ क्योंकि मतलब मेरे पास कुछ AWR है जिसमें heavy load DB का है, तो मतलब वो अगर मैं तो फिर आपको सेंड कर दूंगा तो फायदा होगा हम लोग का, मतलब उसमें सारे
डिस्कस कर लेंगे.
एग्जैक्टली, मतलब सारे इशू दिखेगा उसपे, इसीलिए
ठीक है. ठीक वो एकदम लास्ट में करेंगे क्योंकि बहुत सारा चीज है उसमें, सारा कुछ ही रहता है.
हाँ, exactly. वो मतलब सभी रहते हैं तो उसका पता भी नहीं चलेगा, इसलिए मैं पूछ लिया. ठीक है,
जस्ट मैं बता दिया AWR कुछ एक चीज होता है, बस इतना ही बोला हूँ और कुछ नहीं बताया हूँ. क्रिएट करना कोई बड़ा बात नहीं, पढ़ना ही मेन चीज है. ठीक है, क्रिएट करना तो सब सीख जाओगे.
हर एक पैरामीटर का अलग अलग मतलब ये होता है.
साइज देखना ठीक है. होप यू ऑल आर एबल टू.
यस सर.
ओके, सो पहले चेक कर लो एचआर हमारा इसमें है कि नहीं है. एचआर ठीक है, यहाँ पे क्या क्या हो देखो, ये तुम लोग को थोड़ा बड़ा कर दे रहा हूँ, होप सबको दिख रहा होगा. हाँ, सेलेक्ट स्टार फ्रॉम टैब. व्हाट आई एम डूइंग, सो वी हैव दिस टेबल्स. व्हाट आई एम डूइंग, दिस टेबल इज देयर, सो व्हाटएवर स्ट्रक्चर वी हैव यूज्ड ऑन दैट प्रोसीजर, इसमें टेबल क्रिएट टेबल ईएमपी में दे रहा हूँ. हाँ, एज सिलेक्ट star from EMPLOYES. So extra this new table came with us. ये वाला ओके एंड इफ यू सी ऑल द स्ट्रक्चर इफ यू कॉपी ऑल द स्ट्रक्चर इज जस्ट सेम कॉपी व्हाट वी हैव एंड इन द प्रोसीजर व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस इट हैव ऑल द कॉलम्स लाइक एवरीथिंग इज सेम व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज सो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग हियर दिस इज ऑल्सो लिसन टू लर्न हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू रन स्क्रिप्ट जो मैं कर रहा हूं वही करते हैं हम लोग प्रोडक्शन में भी ओके और एनी दैट एक्चुअल एनवायरमेंट सो जस्ट एग्जिट इट गो एंड गो टू द प्रॉपर फोल्डर राइट नाउ आई एम जस्ट यूजिंग दिस वन बट बेटर प्रैक्टिस टू पुट व्हाट एवर यू आर राइटिंग इन वन फोल्डर विथ योर नेम एंड इट शुड बी इन द बैकअप drive whichever location your backup is to be there you just better create one folder there and put it whatever your experiment or whatever script you are going to have so what I'm doing here this I'm giving proc any name you can give dot sql okay and run it means inside it we are going to copy paste that okay so I have already copied I just pasted it okay and I'm going to save it. If you see, one practice we have to do, always give proper extension to the file you are going to create. Mostly in DBA career, we are going to have two extensions only. One is .sql and another one is .sh, means shell script. Mostly this two only. So we have already means if you see we have this file called proc.this and in this we all know what is inside it okay and this we have to run okay so how to run whichever user you will log in So, two-step process. First, you have to create it. Whatever is written, it should work. What to do so it will work? Whatever file name is there, okay? @ file name. Okay, so it will run. Give enter. See, procedure created. If some error, because they... As a DBA, we used to get script like this. If it comes with some error, one or two or more errors, what to do? Simple, copy that error, paste it into mail, which you got request for, and reply saying that, please fix, it's not working. We are getting this error. They will fix it, send it to us, follow the same process. This is what we used to do. PSQL normally, it's not under DBA profile. If you know, well and good. Knowing the thing is always going to, knowing extra thing is always going to be advantage. Might be some space comes into. You should know. If you know, you remove the space and run it. That's going to save organization time, your time, everybody's time. But if you don't know, logic and all those, nothing to worry. Now, we got the procedure. How to run the procedure? Because we have just created it. But what is the thing? Outcome. The purpose. Purpose is, right now, what is the number of select count star? If you'll give from EMP we created. So see, 107. This is the record. Now, how to run it? Execute, exe, see, execute. Name of the procedure. What is the name? Name, if you'll see, name is this. See, what is the name? This name, okay? Clear? Execute, name of the procedure. Okay. C. semicolon. Once it successfully executed, see the command, means see the output. 3000, as I told you earlier, so this plus 3000 is this. Same, one more time if you'll run. One more time I'm running, not more than that, okay? Because you have to look your whatever means the size or what you have it, okay? So if you see now, same command, I'm just copying copying pasting, okay? Around 9,000 record is there. So we are good with at least for now, for doing, and make sure we have to just do, otherwise from other session, you are not going to going to get record. Any question in this? Because this is nothing to do with PT, but yes, it's day-to-day activity of any DBAs. We used to do this thing. Everybody means whoever is there in this call as a DBA, they know what they're doing. Any question on this? What we have done, why we have done? Because you have to do with your own to get the practice lesson, what I have just requested you in our WhatsApp group. Now, next important part, I'm going to, I'm doing this set. This is the tool what we are going to use to look into the plan, execution plan. Set, auto, trace, on. Same command if you are doing in for you, it is not going to work. Okay, for enabling this, we need to learn few steps. I'll tell you later on. For me, it's done. That's what it ran successfully. Okay. By doing that, what we have achieved. Let me select count star from table name. And you'll be getting, sorry. Select this from see, few things, three set of output we got. What three set? Number one is output. That is usual. This is not new. This is what we used to, or what we all are talking about, execution plan. Take care. This is simple statement. This is simple. But if you'll go a little bit more complex, definitely we are getting complex. What kind of complexer can you? So let me show you the complexity here. Definitely the inside it right now we will not understand. We are not going to discuss on that. But to have a look how it is going to be, the complex one, I'm just writing. Or I'm select. Suppose username while doing this, we are learning another thing, how to check when last time statistic was gathered for a table called EMP. Okay, this is very basic and very important command for all of us, like as a DBA. So table is there, then definitely we'll take owner. We know who is the owner. Apart from that, chain count something is there. We don't know right now what is chain count, but we will know in coming days. and you can say this one, last analyze, okay? Just three. From table name. DP underscore table, where owner equal to, or let it be table, because owner we are going to have many, equal to EMP.
सर सीएसडीबीए से लॉगिन होना जरूरी है, मतलब ये आप एचआर में है शायद, तो देख लीजिए.
लेट मी मेक इट लिटिल स्मॉल, अदरवाइज द थिंग विल नॉट. एक मैं इसको खोल ले रहा हूं, अदरवाइज इन वन पेज इट विल नॉट डिस्प्ले द प्लान, टोटल प्लान. Same copy paste I'll do. See what it is actually, whatever internal path it went into, and for us the table name is db underscore tables, right? But internally Oracle, just see the actual object used internally by Oracle, these all are the object, okay? These all are the different pattern pieces, different tables internally. That is the base table, what we used to say. Okay, so these all are the tables through which it is getting all the output. And here, if you'll go through all the internal process, how the process, how it will do the process to get the output, and by doing all these, which all are the number of byte it is going to be extracting. It's not extracted yet, but this is the concrete plan. Like I said, I have to go to Howrah. I already made decision. I'm going to choose these paths. How the path will look like? Which junction I have to wait on traffic signal? Maybe this or that. Everything is crystal clear before I'll start. So here few things are there. Normally, at first thing, we will be looking whether the table, the scan is, see, different kind of one is this, axis is there, but it is saying index scan. Sometime it is going to tell you full table scan. It is not there anywhere. See, fixed table, what it is saying? Last two, that 23 and 24, if you're able to see it, what is saying? It is doing fixed table but full. So these are the tables. So two takeaway here only. Whether it is using index scan or it is using full scan. Index also, unique scan is there. Index also, full scan is there. So this is table, full scan is there. So what is full table scan? Just what is the takeaway in this full table scan? Whenever we are getting more full table scan, you will be getting almost every time that the number of byte is involved is pretty high. Okay, compared to any you go for index scan anywhere, you'll be getting much more, means much less data. So the bottom line, if we are using index scan, it is going to avoid unnecessary search, resultant very less time you are going to spend to get output. The more, so here, likewise, when we will write, this is not the proper command I have used, because this is the data dictionary, internal tables are getting here. So it's none of our business to just get into all those things. Just main aim for me to display the how plan looks like, execution plan looks like. Though still this query is pretty simple. You are going to get query of 100, 200, 500 line. Which part you will look into to start with, index scan or full scan? If it is full scan, first thing is there, you have to make something so it should do index scan. How, in which situation, what, I'll tell you later on. So takeaway for last 5 minutes is simple. What to do so we will able to see the plan. And I was referring to cost, right? See. Though here load wise nothing is there, but see, whenever you will get
sir, yes. Rows or bytes, isko thoda aap ek baar dekhiye.
Bata raha hu. So byte is simply as a output, which while doing what action, how many byte is getting affected. Matlab kitna byte ko scan kar raha, kitna byte ko le raha. Okay. Cost is here, you can think as a whole percentage. Matlab is query ko run karne ke liye, is query ko run karne ke liye, to run this query, which activity is taking total, suppose 100% CPU it is taking. Out of that, which part is getting as a whole, which means what percentage of CPU. So if you'll see actual, whenever we will, I'll show you the actual, the different kind of statement I'll run, you will be getting this percentage is going to be a little higher. Because this query or this statement I ran on the base table or the data dictionary table. So this is going to be high. The more this, the more cost is percentage wise. So our aim will be what? To reduce it. You are going to get much more time. Our main aim will be what to do so that time in every phase will decrease. So let me show you the actual queries one by one, and we will discuss these thing along with what it is doing here. Here, main thing, we all have gone through something called gets and miss while doing the architecture. Consistent get, physical read, we all have a little idea. I'll tell you what is physical read, though we know. Redo size, what is total size is coming as the output we are going to get. And this is very important, this part. So this thing I'll be showing you just by good writing practice, bad writing practice. I started with saying that same query, we can write in many ways. Which way is good one and why? Okay, so let me show you one by one the query which I already sent you. And you will come to know which one is good and why. So
सर इसपे जो रोज का जो काउंट रहता है इसका मतलब क्या होता है मतलब इतना दो रोज को इसको फेस करने के बाद रिजल्ट मिला है ऐसा क्या
दिखा रहा हूँ बता रहा हूँ कि क्योंकि क्योंकि वहां पर कुछ आउटपुट उस तरह से है नहीं हम लोग का तो take example of this one first. One of the best practice is never use star. Sir, हम लोग तो practice के लिए करते हैं, practice के लिए अभी भी करेंगे. If we are going to use all the columns, we are going to use the column name. All the, maybe whole column. We are going to. Why? If we will use this way, it is going to. Cost wise, it is going to take less cost. Star, it is going to take. The optimizer is going to use more cost to this. So, resultant, it is going to take a little bit more time compared to this. This is a standard practice. Okay? It's not. Means explained or given by me. This is a standard practice. Now, because star is there, so you will try later on with your own. You have all the tool. So few, I'll just never use distinct in your statement until unless it's very, very urgent. See the difference. I'll use distinct and I'll use without distinct. Same command is there. And see the difference in the cost. I'm going to the user this one, I think. Oh. Just copy, paste. I'll just run both the query and you will able to just see without understanding much. Sorry, I have to set auto trace on and I have to run this query. Let me set line size. I'm giving 200. Yes, it makes more sense. Now, see here. See the cost only, okay? Just at least big number, small number, we can understand. Here we are not going to just do more research, but at least we should able to understand by using distinct what is coming and without using distinct what is coming. So here, see the, if you'll compare the byte affected, the cost affected, okay. Time is though the output is very tiny compared to the actual scenario. So at least we will come to know something here. number wise, and the same number we will compare without using distinct keyword. Okay, same thing, same query I'm writing, and see select this one, and if you see the comparison, I think it was there 50 or something related to that, and see the effect on the, if you'll go see. So impact wise, definitely on the both the cases, if you see the time, output time, it is going to be almost same, but the volume, the moment the volume of the table will increase, the output is start coming too late. Okay, so everything is same. See, byte, and if you'll compare both, let me just compare both, okay? And I'll put in notepad side by side, and you'll, this is, copy. I'll increase the font, don't worry. Let me put. This is good one, and this is distinct one. I think I copy wrongly. Copy. So see the comparison, this one cost ka, CPU ka, see? This one, 50-50, this, and one more thing. See the layer of label of work. It's went one deep down. So one extra, see, 0 to 5. Here, 0 to 4. So only putting one keyword called distinct for only few records, few hundred record, the difference, if you'll compare percent wise, around maybe 70 to 80% cost extra we can able to see, and if it will keep, the number of record will be higher, we will be getting the impact on the application side. If you'll click on report with distinct, it will, or it might hang, just remove it, you'll get the thing. So unknowingly sometime it's not needed. Why we are using distinct? To avoid duplicate value, right? There is a whole aim, what we know. That can be tackled in a different way. Or it might happen that the team were expecting if something duplicate will come. We all know primary key is there. No question arises for duplicate record, right? So why to use distinct? Unnecessary. Clear? So good and bad. So hope you all are getting little clear picture what cost we are referring to.
So what does it mean, cost 4 and cost 3? Percentage of CPU, understand.
Uh-huh.
Cost 4.
No. Interesting. these cost and all, it's internal. There are different level of their execution techniques are there, right? How deep it went, why it is more, because it is getting deeper process wise to get some output. See, in the bottom it's a 3 or 2. So the more, if you'll see while doing, the more number of records or volume of, if you'll keep working, the percent, see, the whatever is there in the bracket, so-called percent, CPU percent, it will go increase, keep increasing, and this cost will go higher. Means 4K, 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, like that, it will go. So it is the intensity of the CPU getting involved while doing processing. Okay, so here what to compare. The lesser the percentage of CPU use, what should we do so it is going to be lesser? So there are n number of technique the optimizer is going to use. And each and every here like distinct. If we'll go through a few more, you'll come to know all, not only distinct, there are n number of factors which is going to impact the performance. Impact the performance means high intensive use of our resource. And one of the high intense here is the processor. And more these things are definitely, if you have the more volume of data, this thing is going to increase huge way, means very big way. Because whatever things is getting done internally, in the both the cases, output time we are hardly able to differentiate. Both are same for us, right? Whatever output we are getting, with distinct, without distinct also. But see the internal things, what is happening. But once the volume will increase, definitely you will able to see the dramatic difference. And to do that, to get the time difference, we used to use a very basic thing here. Set or set timing on. If we know, well and good. If we don't know, we should. And set time on. Timing on means it will source the time, whichever statement it took how long. Like, suppose I'm giving select count star from table name. Okay. So where we are. So user, I'm into sys. So same command I have to give hr dot. If we want to off, set auto trace off, on and off only we have learned so far.
Sir, ये auto trace के लिए मेरा एक ही question है. मतलब मैं जिस user से login किया हूँ, अगर मैं उस पे auto trace को एक बार on करूँ, फिर जैसे आपने जैसे plan लिखा, हम लोग तो 100 plan करके निकलते हैं, ठीक है, अलग बात है, छोड़िए. पर जैसे आपने लिखा था, अगर मैं auto trace को on करके निकालू, फिर auto trace off कर दो, मतलब ये जो timing span है, उसके लिए कि हर एक user के लिए auto trace on हो जा रहा है कि फिर मेरा user का, मतलब मैं जिस पे login हूँ उससे कुछ.
तुम जिस सेशन में, तुम जिस सेशन में लॉगिन किए उसी में होगा, सबके लिए नहीं होगा.
ओके,
अब सबके लिए कैसे करते नहीं करते, we will learn. There are different techniques are there. We will focus on two. एक ये है, this is a basic standard one what we all are practicing. If we don't use any tool, if tool is there, different story. We can use.
नहीं सर, जैसे एक चीज होता ना, मतलब मैं PLCL से हम लोग जो PLCL छोड़े, SQL से हम लोग जैसे निकलते कि plan का has been को देख और show plan execute करके जो comment देके निकलते SQL plan, उससे भी निकलता है plan, वो बात नहीं है. मतलब इस पे जैसे आपका execute हो जा रहा है SQL, उस पे execute नहीं होगा, सिर्फ plan दिखाएगा.
No, we'll come to that part also. Here we can have only that what you are asking. No need to go. This is the simplest one. Okay, this is the simple.
मतलब इस पे सिर्फ मेरा session के लिए होगा और कुछ नहीं. ठीक है.
ठीक है. Wait.
Let me finish, then I'll come to question. See, so how long it will take? So hardly, see, but the fraction of second we need, right? So, but the moment how we will compare, the moment you will get any query, you will run and see how long it is taking this. Okay, so it is going to come maybe 30 seconds, 40 seconds, maybe 1 minute. And you will do some tuning, it should reflect in maybe few seconds. Because cost and all those things internally just to do the diagnostic and all those kind. But how to get the impact? End user will not see what is cost and this, they will not understand that much from development point of view or developer team. They want, it was running in maybe more than 5 minutes it was taking. Now it should take maybe less than a minute or something. So they will be happy. Or whatever time they told us that maybe 5 minutes, you are just reduced to maybe 2 minutes, still they are going to be happy more than 100%. You have just improved. Okay, so set auto trace, set this one time on, and one more, set timing on. The moment set timing on, and time on. The moment you'll give time on, so when you started, the moment you will hit enter, so that also here also you will able to see ki 46 mein output aaya, is samay diya tha. So took how as a whole, kab kitna samay tum chalaya the nahi. So set time on, set timing on. Two things are there, so it will just keep track of the time, how long it will it took. And as a whole, at what time you have started, those kind of thing. Okay, now next what I'm showing, the same thing, but different command I'm firing. And we will see the difference again. The whole difference we are trying to discuss here, kaun sa achha hai aur kyun hai, which one is bad and why. Okay, so the next one is, whenever we have learned so far for joining what? This is gone. I'm just making a little bit more simple because I don't want to. See, first, see whether we are able to get the basic concept here or not. What we are doing, though we all have idea about SQL, what we are doing here. Dhyan se ek bar dekho isko, query ko dono.
So department or employee table ko join.
Huh. We are doing join, and then what we are doing at last.
सर
पहले एक काम करते हैं, केवल ज्वाइन का ही ये करते हैं. हाँ, सो अननेसेसरी वी आर हैविंग, सो सेम क्वेरी आई कैन जस्ट राइट इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑन दिस. तो लेट मी राइट यहाँ पे थोड़ा चेंज करना पड़ेगा बिकॉज वी हैव यूज्ड हियर employees, and but we are having record, more record on EMP. So anyways, first same query I'm writing. Yahan pe main count hata de raha hun, theek hai? Same query rakhe, main count mein hata raha hun. Make it just simple. इसको मैं हटा दिया फ्रॉम department, energy and this, there. This is one query, and what we have learned, depend my department name from department. One more. Select, suppose I'm giving employee's name is there or what? Can anyone have idea which employees? I think select last name. Last name is there, one. Last name I'm taking and department ID from this. From EMPLOY, employees, comma, this one, where employee ID equal to department ID, I think this one.
Sir, last name of which table, sir?
Now, first tell me whether this query will run or not. I didn't mention it, okay? So what will happen? This is not nothing to do with PT, okay? Simple. Will it run? Yes or no? Because see, what we are doing, last name, department this, and department name. So we want to just show department ID name and who is working under that from this two table where this is this. So anybody can come, or I'm just removing this also, okay? I'm removing this also from this and department. Let me run it. Let me fix that itself. Employee dot department ID equal to
employees होगा ना सर
टेबल हाँ employees होगा हाँ department ID employees dot this equal to department a department table right for the departments. So bottom line, what I'm trying to show you, and you will get it, the way of writing this query, what we have learned from day one, okay, not good. Okay, this is not good. And on what basis? Instead of this, we will be using the inner query. दिस इज रॉन्ग वे ऑफ राइटिंग क्वेरी. तो इनर क्वेरी मतलब कौन सा, ये वाला. ऑलरेडी सैंपल में तुम लोगों को भी मैं दिया हूं. टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ एनीवन. See, hope, just go through the query once, huh? So this inner join on this output, it is going to be same. Concept is same. Ultimate, we are fetching data from two table and displaying it. Nothing else. Here also, if you'll go through the query, we are fetching data from two table, to matlab employee and department, and doing join. But output, the cost wise, it is going to be very different. Departments aur kuch galti hai departments, so yahan pe let me change it. Depart. So same to have where to mess. Departments hai, departments hai. Okay. See the level to just get the at least or kuch nahi dikha raha hu, just iska dekho, ha 17 hai aur isi mein hum log run karwaye the na, theek hai. See, double. One more thing is, see the depth means kitna, how deeper it went. In this one, that means so-called, we are saying good one. See, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So total is 6 level of deep drive it done. Okay. But if you'll see there on top, that means so-called bad one. See, 9 level of work is have to done to get the same. Now, those just we have to feel it here saying that the volume of data is not the way what we are getting here. The volume of data is maybe 1,000 times more. And each and every deep dive, deeper label is going to be very, 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 very costly. So why good? Why bad? These are the standard practice. We will not be using for learning. That's okay. But we have to keep these small, small things in mind. So hope at least we are getting idea little bit costly kis base pe bol rahe hai. Simple hai, CPU ka percentage jyada lag raha aur kuch samajh mein aaya nahi hai, itna to aa raha hai. And label of work, if you'll compare the time, the more deeper the more layer is there, more inner label is there, more time will be there adding into execution process. And more time as a whole, cost plus time, ultimately result is going to be very bad. Any question on this too, at least to get the idea good and bad? Anybody?
Sir, percentage CPU utilization 34 pe aa gaya. Magar cost badh ke 6 pe chala gaya, aisa kaise hua?
Nahi nahi, wo kaisa hua wo nahi, wo andar mein kya kar raha tha, na tum dekhne ja rahe ho nahi na hum dekhne ja rahe hain. Theek hai. The thing what we need to, what is the level of cost, that means CPU percentage is using here, and what is the percentage using here? वो लेवल समझना है तो उसका एल्गोरिदम कैसे काम करता है वो देखना पड़ेगा कितना ये लगा है. एक ही काम उसको करने के लिए इसी में हाफ द टाइम इट इज टेकिंग. लोड वाइज हाफ द लोड इज देयर, क्योंकि हम हार्डली इट्स अ फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकंड. इफ यू विल सी द आउटपुट, इवन वी आर नॉट गेटिंग अ सेकंड, बट what we are trying to understand here, good and bad, and why good and bad.
सर मेरा दो क्वेश्चन है
बोलो
सर एक चीज अब देखिए ये हम लोग का मतलब जब क्वेरी में एक लाइन में अगर कोई पूछे कि इस क्वेरी का कॉस्ट क्या है तो हम लोग इसी को बोलते हैं मतलब जो एकदम टॉप वाला रो पे आ रहा है ठीक है जैसे कि इसका सिक्स आया यूनिट ठीक है सीपीयू में मतलब और नीचे में तो इसमें और भी दो तीन चीज जो हम लोग देखते हैं जैसे कि बाइट्स टाइम रोज एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा ठीक है इसमें मेरा एक ही डाउट क्लियर करना है जैसे कि आप मान लीजिए अब दोनों प्लानिंग में अब देखिए ऊपर में एक डीपर ज्यादा हो गया राइट ऊपर में नीच में मतलब जो बिलो आपने एग्जीक्यूट किया पर अभी देखिए उसमें ये जो बाइट्स और रोज है ठीक है बाइट्स तो हो गया कि कितना बाइट्स डेटा इसने एनालिसिस किया फॉर फेचिंग द रिकॉर्ड्स ओके एंड रोज का मतलब क्या होता है मतलब कितना रोज ये इसका मतलब एनालिसिस किया है कि ये फेच करने के लिए ऐसा ही ना
नहीं नहीं रो मतलब कितना रो को टच किया है नॉट नेसेसरी कि वो उसमें का डेटा लेगा ही कितना रो को प्रोसेस किया है वो
एग्जैक्टली मतलब इस रोज का ऊपर काम हुआ है मतलब इसके ऊपर अब देखिए
ऐसा हो
एग्जैक्टली तो अब क्या होता है मैं आपको एक चीज बोल रहा हूँ अब देखिए किसी किसी क्वेरी का मतलब ये जो कॉस्ट है ना मतलब सीपीयू का जो कॉस्ट हमने 17% अभी जो हम लोग सिर्फ देख रहे हैं कि सीपीयू बढ़ रहा है या कम रहा है ऐसा कभी कभी होता है कि आप देखिए सीपीयू का परसेंटेज तो कम हो जाता है पर ये रोज का नंबर बढ़ जाता है ठीक है तो वो गुड है या बैड है और कभी कभी क्या होता है रोज का नंबर कम हो जाता है बाइट्स कम हो जाता है सीपीयू का मतलब परसेंटेज ज्यादा हो जाते हैं तो हम लोग क्या सिर्फ सीपीयू को ही कंसीडर करें या फिर इन सब को भी कंसीडर में रखना
नहीं दो दो चीज हम लोग टू थिंग वी यूज टू कंसीडर द फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट सी द बाइट थिंग दैट मींस द नंबर ऑफ सी इफ यू सी द डिफरेंट लेबल ऑन सो बाइट मींस व्हाट इट इज सिंपली सेइंग दैट दैट नंबर ऑफ
स्टोरेज और नथिंग एल्स मतलब इतना स्पेस में ये काम किया है बाइट
हां दैट कैरेक्टर गॉट स्कैन हम लोग के नजर में उतना कैरेक्टर टच किया है
या फिर यूनिट ऑफ स्पेस मतलब जितना स्पेस में इतने ये
हुआ है स्पेस बोलना गलत होगा क्योंकि स्पेस इट माइट हैपन इट माइट स्कैन 1 MB एंड फाइंड ओनली 1 रिकॉर्ड और 1 बाइट सो वो नहीं कंसीडर करेंगे अल्टीमेटली हाउ मच इट कम्स एज आउटपुट उसके लिए क्या करना पड़ा नहीं पड़ा देयर आर मोर फैक्टर्स आर देयर इन द बॉटम कितना रिकर्सिव कॉल है क्या नहीं है दोस थिंग्स आर कमिंग ओके बट हियर द क्वेश्चन इज सर सीपीयू वाला देखेंगे ना बाइट का देखेंगे डेफिनेटली सबसे पहले ये दो चीज देखते हैं हम लोग ये वाला टाइम कितना लग रहा है लोड कितना पड़ रहा हो सकता है इन फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकंड इट इज प्रोसेसिंग मोर रिकॉर्ड दैट्स ओके टू गेट द आउटपुट सो अल्टीमेट व्हाट should we consider or the time ultimately for us two things load bahut bhagna nahi chahiye time kam mein mere ko chahiye that is a, always we are just keeping in right load bhi nahi bade aur mere ko time kam mein mere ko data chahiye so we will be considering this too though the volume of data is pretty less here we are not getting any time here in this but this is this two last two parameters going to be
तो मतलब इसमें कितना रोज और बाइट्स उसको इग्नोर कर सकता है मतलब इसको कंसीडर करने का जरूरत नहीं है राइट मतलब हम लोग सिर्फ कितना परसेंटेज ऑफ सीपीयू यूज हो रहा है और कितना इलैप्स टाइम है वो दोनों मेन चीज है
हां 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 सो अल्टीमेटली वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन द टाइम ठीक है क्योंकि अगला वो लोड बढ़े ठीक है वो सीपीयू ऐड करवा देगा ये उतना होता नहीं है अल्टीमेटली टू बी ऑनेस्ट एज पर प्रैक्टिकल द टाइप ऑफ सर्वर वी यूज्ड टू गेट इट्स गुड टू हैंडल ऑल दिस थिंग बट अल्टीमेटली ये ज्यादा पड़ेगा इसमें ये अल्टीमेटली ज्यादा रहता ही रहता है ये कम हो जाएगा मतलब अल्टीमेटली ये कम होता है मतलब एज पर माय पर्सनल ये सो ये दोनों को हम लोग बढ़ाएंगे एंड राइट नाउ वी आर नॉट डूइंग ट्यूनिंग फॉर द स्पीक्स वी आर कंसिडरिंग गुड एंड बैड वे
ओके सर
ठीक है सो कौन सा क्या है कौन सा ठीक है बुरा क्यों है इसीलिए है दैट इज द पॉइंट मैंने टू स्टार्ट विद बोला था कि देयर आर सम स्टैंडर्ड प्रैक्टिसेस आर देयर राइट व्हाई इट इज सर बोल दिया आप ये क्यों है तो अभी तक केवल डेवलपमेंट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से जो बंदे हैं उनको बोला जाता गाइडेंस रहता है एक व्हेनेवर दे यूज्ड टू कम देयर इज अ डीबीए टीम से एक मीटिंग होता है उसमें बोला जाता है ये स्टैंडर्ड प्रैक्टिस है देयर आर डिफरेंट नेमिंग कन्वेंशन वी हैव टू फॉलो दिस नेम सम सेट ऑफ रूल्स और गाइडेंस देयर वी हैव टू बट व्हाई हम लोग को खुद को तो कन्विंस होना पड़ेगा ना पहले सो कॉस्ट ज्यादा आता है टाइम ज्यादा लगेगा
बट ये सर जो कॉस्ट जो दिख रहा है ये पूरा का पूरा मतलब पूरा जो आपने सीक्यूएल डाला पूरा टास्क को कंप्लीट होने में इतना प्रोसेस हो रहा है राइट मतलब
exactly.
ऐसा नहीं कि एक रो के लिए या फिर दो रो के लिए ऐसा नहीं है टोटल जो टास्क है इसके लिए मुझे इतना कंसीडर करना पड़ेगा
और इतना डीप लेवल में किया है क्या किया है ये हम लोगों को पता नहीं है अभी तक स्कैन क्या होता है इंडेक्स स्कैन क्या होता है ये सब हम लोग अभी पता नहीं विल डिस्कस लिटिल बिट मोर डिटेल बट अल्टीमेटली
मतलब पूरा टास्क को कंप्लीट होने में इतना मुझे कॉस्ट और सीपीयू को कंसीडर करना पड़ेगा
ठीक है मतलब ये पिक्चर ही देखते हैं और उसके बाद दिस थिंग विल इंपैक्ट ऑन बेसिस ऑफ व्हाट स्कैन यू आर डूइंग इसके ऊपर बहुत ही वाइटल ये करता है देखना यहाँ पे जितना भी इंडेक्स स्कैन हो रहा है देखना सीपीयू कॉस्ट अपने आप डाउन हो जाएगा और जितना भी फुल टेबल स्कैन हो रहा है कंपैरेटिवली सीपीयू कॉस्ट उठेगा और जितना ज्यादा ज्वाइनिंग हो रहा है उसमें और ज्यादा उठेगा तो ज्वाइनिंग में ज्यादा उठे तो छोड़ दे ज्वाइनिंग तो फिर ज्वाइनिंग सीखे क्यों है बट डेफिनेटली द पर्पस इज टू डू ज्वाइन वो तो करना ही है बट वेयर वी कैन रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट जो बाय डूइंग सम ऑफ द अदर ट्रिक वन ऑफ द ट्रिक इज इंडेक्स और डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ इंडेक्स दैट विल डिस्कस लेटर ऑन बट अभी जस्ट टेक अवे फॉर दिस डिस्कशन ओनली गुड एंड बैड व्हाई गुड एंड बैड दैट्स इट एंड हाउ टू रीड एग्जीक्यूशन प्लान few part we have touched nothing more than that okay now the last thing I'll take more only 5 minutes okay I know little bit late we are running here now sir mere ko ye abhi statistics ke bare mein dekhna hi nahi hai mere ko keval plan dekhna hai so there are few options available the someone was saying some time back set auto suppose we don't remember the syntax just simple auto deke enter maro these all are the options available we all know on off we know right iske sath set a u t o t r a c these options are there huh on off we know I want only explain plan, nothing else. Output भी नहीं चाहिए और stats भी ये जो stats का ये है ये भी नहीं चाहिए हमको. Set auto trace on. EXP explain पूरा लिखो, ठीक है? या EXP लिख दो. And the query what we have is this, right? We are getting only plan the reason normally we used to use this way only in CY in command prompt because sometime what happened thousands of rows are there it will keep coming we have to wait for maybe 2-3 minutes
mere ko aur ek cheez bhi hota hai sir jaise ki ek naya query aa gaya agar hum log usko pura execute kar de matlab database hang ho jayegi us query check exactly. karne ke liye sir diya gaya hai
exactly so we have to just focus on plan only How to do this? Set auto trace on करके explain कर लो. केवल stats से ये, केवल trace से ये. That options also there. यहाँ पे जैसे इसे देख लेते हैं. Set. See. केवल stats चाहिए. On करके केवल stats दे दो. वो नीचे का जो दिख रहा था ना. अभी उतना हम लोगों को पता नहीं. थोड़ा सा detail हम लोग उसमें जाएंगे. Not today, but set auto trace on. Then stat. ये वाला. ठीक है तो इसमें देखो साथ में क्या आया है देखो आउटपुट भी आया है और एक ऑप्शन क्या है जो कि सेट और एक ऑप्शन है ट्रेस ठीक है ये देखो सेट ऑटो ट्रेस ऑन Set auto trace TRS क्या गलती कर रहा हूँ
सर auto trace auto के बाद एक bracket है
नहीं auto
trace सर set auto trace
auto
double T हो गया
set AUTOTRAC ठीक है
ऑटो ट्रेस सर
ठीक है
ऑन और ट्रेस एक साथ नहीं होगा ना सर ये और है ना ऑफ है ऑन है या और है ट्रेस
ट्रेस तो दिया था ना इसके पहले में थोड़ा अच्छा तो टाइप हुआ था एनीवे सो व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग हियर सी यहां पे केवल तो ये दिस इज द डिफॉल्ट वन नॉर्मली वी यूज्ड टू प्रेफर ठीक है सो नो आउटपुट ओनली और साथ में एग्जीक्यूशन प्लान सो ट्रेस विल गिव अस दिस थिंग आउटपुट को मेरे को अवॉइड करना है सो ऑल द ऑप्शंस सुमन जो थोड़ी देर पहले बोल रहे थे सेम थिंग वी कैन डू हियर आल्सो नो नीड टू डू एनी एक्स्ट्रा सेटिंग ऑन ऑल दोस ठीक है सो ये और एक दो क्वेरी होगा
सर इस पे क्वेरी एग्जीक्यूट तो नहीं हो जाएगा ना मतलब
नहीं नहीं इसके और प्लान दिखा रहा है और कितना टाइम लगेगा वो सब दिख जाएगा तुमको
ठीक
ये प्लान मेनली प्लान देखने के लिए करते हैं हम लोग कि क्या है क्या नहीं है क्या कहां पे क्या कॉस्ट ले रहा है कहां पे क्या करने से और क्वेरी का ऑर्डर चेंज करने से वी विल बी गेटिंग ड्रामेटिक आउटपुट ठीक है तो इसमें मैंने जो दिया देखना हैविंग बोलकर एक होगा वो लगा के देखना हैविंग अगर हम लोग लगाते हैं टू थिंग वन इज वेयर क्लॉज वन इज हैविंग देयर आर लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस कौन सा आगे पीछे करने से पूरा आउटपुट का जो टाइम का पूरा मतलब अपसाइड डाउन हो जाता है एक में तुम अगर करोगे बाय डिफॉल्ट ऐसे 10 मिनट लग सकता है सिंपल ऑर्डर चेंज करने से पूरा वो फ्यू सेकंड लगेगा तो वो क्वेरी भी दिया हुआ है उसमें हैविंग का है देखना वो एक बार चला के जस्ट देखना यू विल गेट द थिंग व्हाट वी ऑल आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कॉस्ट वाइज तीन चार ऑप्शन है वो चला जो मैं किया वही करना जस्ट एक बार देखना क्योंकि दीज आर द थिंग्स वी हैव टू डू इट लिटिल बिट जब भी परफॉर्मेंस ट्यूनिंग्स का आता है ये हमको करना है एंड व्हेन नेक्स्ट वी विल कम वी विल जस्ट डिस्कस लिटिल बिट मोर डीपर इनटू दिस आज जस्ट इंट्रोडक्शन हम लोग किए हैं बट इसको थोड़ा सा समझना पड़ेगा कौन सा ये सॉर्ट जॉइन है या ये एक्सेस फिल्टर क्या है या स्टैट्स में ये ब्लॉक रीड ये सब के बारे में थोड़ा सा आइडिया होना चाहिए ये बहुत ही जरूरी है मेमोरी सॉर्ट डिस्क सॉर्ट कब होता है कैसे होता है इसको हम लोग को जितना होगा मेमोरी सॉर्ट ही करवाएंगे डिस्क सॉर्ट नहीं करवाएंगे डिस्क सॉर्ट नहीं करवाने के लिए क्या करना है सो इट्स राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस प्लस इसके बारे में अगर होता है तो क्यों होता है वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड ठीक है तो आज के लिए इतना ही वी विल जस्ट मीट नेक्स्ट सैटरडे ठीक है अगर
नहीं बोला ना वो ऑटो ट्रेस ऑन हम लोगों का कंप्यूटर में नहीं होगा
नहीं तो तुम लोगों का नहीं होगा तो इसमें ये कर लेना ना यहाँ पे सिस में तो होगा डॉट करके चला लेना यू लेबल टू डू इट राइट वो करेंगे वो तो बताएंगे
सिस से होगा
हाँ हाँ सिस से तो होगा सिस से मैंने कुछ नहीं किया सिस में बाय डिफॉल्ट इसमें परमिशन एक स्क्रिप्ट फाइल है खुद से तुम लोग ट्राई करो एक ट्रेस फाइल रहता है उसको ऑन करना होता है जब एरर आएगा ना वो करना एक स्क्रिप्ट को रन करवा के एक परमिशन देना रहता है यू एबल टू डू विथ योर ओन नहीं होगा मैं करके दिखा दूंगा खुद से ट्राई एक बार करना एक स्क्रिप्ट रहता है उसको चलाना होता है वो चलाने से एक रोल बन जाता है वो रोल को ग्रांट करना पड़ता है एचआर को या स्कॉट को जिसमें तुम चलाओगे ये दो स्टेप है केवल खुद से करोगे इट्स मैटर ऑफ मैं करूंगा तभी दो मिनट लगेगा और दो मिनट करने से वो स्पून फीडिंग हो जाएगा मैं अभी करूंगा नहीं एकदम नहीं होगा फिर मैं कर दूंगा ठीक है तो
सर मेरा और एक क्वेश्चन है इस पे सर आपने एक बार हाँ. बोला था ना मतलब ये ऑटो ट्रेस ऑन करने से लॉग वग वगैरह ज्यादा नहीं बढ़ जाएगा ना मतलब
नहीं नहीं वो दूसरा चीज है उसको मिक्स मत करो इससे वो हम लोग करेंगे
इसीलिए क्योंकि मैं ऑटो ट्रेस कभी किया नहीं इसलिए पूछा मैं सिर्फ एक्सप्लेन प्लान शो करके देखता हूं
वो भयंकर वो गंदा वो करेंगे हम लोग मैं बोला ना दो तीन दो तरीका हम लोग करेंगे
प्रोडक्शन एनवायरनमेंट है तो मतलब छूट जाएगा तो मतलब एकदम हो जाएगी इसीलिए मैं पूछ ले एक बार
नहीं वो सारा हम लोग करेंगे स्लोली एक साथ हड़बड़ाओ मत सब जितना बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस होता है मैं एटलीस्ट जितना करता हूँ वो सब तुम लोगों को सिखाऊंगा ठीक
है सर ओके सर गुड नाइट
मोटामोटी काफी रहेगा चिंता मत ठीक है एनी क्वेश्चन related to this related to any other thing
pucha the auto trace or spool different hai ek
hai sir ha total different hai dono pura zameen aasman ka farak hai spool bata dunga next din mein kya hai wo spool ka basically isse hamara performance tuning se koi link nahi hai
okay
theek hai ha
spool se application team leta hai matlab uska query ka output aur error wagera dekhne ke liye
ha whatever activity suppose I am doing as a right now you want to keep track of all everything kyunki yahan to nikal gaya sab khatam ho gaya na wo to rahega nahi that you want to keep track and you want to save it permanently. जैसे ये मैं क्या क्या step किया, मान लो तुमको देखना है जानना है, तो इसको हम लोग क्या करते हैं, spool, ये शुरू में ही मैं spool on कर देता, ये सारा एक file में जाता, last में spool off कर दूंगा, वो file में permanently वो रह गया. तो उसके लिए
वो फाइल कहाँ पर रहता है सर,
सेफ जिस लोकेशन से तुम लॉगिन करोगे, मतलब हमारे केस में मैं अगर करूंगा तो यहाँ पे करूंगा, यहाँ इस लोकेशन पे रहेगा. कैसे होता मैं अभी दिखा ही देता हूँ, जिसको जल्दी है निकल सकते हो, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. ठीक है, ये हम लोग का पीटी का नहीं है, इसलिए मैं स्पूल कोई भी नाम दे दो. सपोज मैं दे रहा हूँ SHA1. Any extension you can give, but ये SQL का रहता है, generally we used to give SQL या test, TST, कुछ भी दे सकते हो, नहीं भी दे सकते हो. Okay, spool ये किया, I want to run suppose this command. Okay, so इसको मैं run किया, इस तरह से whatever activity you want to do, just keep doing it. Once you done, suppose तुमको और कुछ करना नहीं है, काम हो गया हमारा, घर जाना है, इसको SPOOLOFF, spool off कर दो. And if you'll see exclamation देके यहाँ पे करेंगे, देखो ये फाइल बन गया, right? और इसको अगर खोलकर देखोगे, मान लो मैं इसको, इसमें सारा कुछ जो जो कमांड या आउटपुट है, ठीक है, वो हम लोग कहते हैं ये देखो सारा इसमें है, ये कमांड चलाए थे ना, और ये इस तरह का आउटपुट है, ये देखो सारा दिख रहा है यहाँ पे, स्पूल ऑफ किए, ये हो गया. That's it. ये इसी को बोलते हैं स्पूल. इससे हम लोग का परफॉर्मेंस ट्यूनिंग का कुछ लिंक नहीं है, लेकिन बहुत ही यूजफुल है ये, हम लोग बहुत मतलब बहुत ही यूजफुल है. कभी कभी डेवलपमेंट टीम से आता है, ठीक है, ये जो क्वेरी है उसका आउटपुट, क्योंकि उन लोगों को परमिशन रहता नहीं है, तो परमिशन नहीं है तो नेचुरली हर क्वेरी को वो लोग रन करवा नहीं पाते हैं. कोई कोई क्वेरी का आउटपुट थोड़ा ज्यादा या ये रहता है, उसका रिस्ट्रिक्शन रहता है प्रोफाइल में, क्वेरी विल फेल If they will run, क्योंकि उनका रहता है कितना बाइट से ज्यादा अगर एक क्वेरी में आता है उसको फेल, मतलब प्रोफाइलिंग में सेट रहता है. बट यू डोंट, एज अ डीबीए वी डोंट हैव एनी रिस्ट्रिक्शन, तो इसका आउटपुट कभी कभी लोग मांगते हैं, तो आउटपुट कैसे दोगे तुम, क्वेरी का आउटपुट आया है कैसे तुम ये करोगे. तो स्पूल ऑन कर दो, स्पूल फाइल नेम, आउटपुट आ गया, ऑफ कर दो, ये आउटपुट को जिप करके जैसे करके उनको दे दो. लाइक वाइज देयर आर मेनी यूजेस ऑफ इट. ठीक है,
सो थोड़ा सा ऊपर करेंगे सर, स्पूल ऑन के बाद क्या एक्टिविटी की
है? स्पूल के बाद मैंने ये वाला जस्ट स्पूल ऑन नहीं किया था,
okay.
ये वाला, हाँ, फाइल नेम दिया हूँ, मतलब ये जो भी है वो फाइल में जाएगा, जो फाइल, हाँ, उसको कैप्चर करना था, इस फाइल में जाएगा. स्पूल ऑफ करोगे तो, अगर बाई चांस स्पूल ऑफ किए हुए बंद कर दिए सेशन तो तुमको कुछ मिलेगा नहीं, लेकिन ब्लैंक जीरो बाइट फाइल रहेगा. ऑफ करना जरूरी है एकदम, नहीं करोगे कुछ भी तुम्हारा सेव नहीं होगा. स्पूल ऑफ मींस यू आर सेविंग ऑल द डिटेल्स व्हाट यू एग्जीक्यूटेड आफ्टर स्पूलिंग ऑन. ठीक है,
ओके सर, थैंक यू, गुड नाइट.
ओके.